Again, welcome to the chemistry session. Today we are discussing part 2 of the chapter number 4, chemical bonding. The word bond is associated with various kinds of terminologies such as bond order, bond enthalpy, bond strength, bond length, etc. So in this video, we'll discuss in depth how the definition goes on and how they can be applied in various kinds of phenomena related to chemical bonding.
The topics covered are as follows: bond length, bond enthalpy, bond order, resonance, and VSEPR, that is valence shell electron pair repulsion theory. Bond length. It is defined as the equilibrium distance between the centers of the nuclei of the two bonded atoms. It is expressed in the terms of A and can also be defined by X-ray diffraction studies. Next topic is bond angle. It is defined as the angle between the lines that are representing the orbitals having bonding electrons. They help to determine the geometry and shape of a molecule and are expressed in the form of degrees. Bond enthalpy is the energy required to break one mole of bonds of a particular type of compound and finally to separate them into gaseous atoms. They are expressed in the unit of kilojoules per mole and they are simply called as bond dissociation enthalpy responsible for breaking one mole of bonds. Bond order. According to Lewis, while forming covalent bond, bond order is given by the formula: the number of bonds present between the two atoms participating to form a molecule. For example, a single bond exists while the formation of hydrogen molecule takes place. So the bond order is equal to 1. Likewise, for oxygen it is 2 and for nitrogen the bond order is 3. Isoelectronic molecules and ions, they have equal or same bond orders. For example, fluorine and oxide, they have bond order 1. Similarly, nitrogen, carbon monoxide and nitronium ion have bond order equal to 3. When we increase the bond order, the enthalpy required to break the bonds also increases due to the fact that bond length decreases. The next topic is resonance and resonance structures. These structures are the major molecules whose behavior cannot be explained by the representation of a single Lewis structure. For the entire representation, we need the combination of resonating structures. The Lewis structure of ozone is represented below. The other concepts connected to resonance is that whenever a single Lewis structure cannot explain all sorts of properties of a molecule, then it is supposed to have many number of structures with similar energies. These structures are also called canonical structures that form a resonance hybrid which describes the molecule accurately. For particularly ozone molecule, two structures shown above are canonical structures and the third structure represents the ozone hybrid, also called the resonance hybrid. Polarity of bonds. Some molecules are polar in nature and some non-polar. Non-polar covalent compounds, when the atoms joined by the covalent bond are same, like hydrogen molecule, oxygen molecule, etc., then the shared pair of electrons are equally distributed and attracted by the two atoms, and thus the shared electron pair is at equal distance between both of them. So we can say that they lie exactly in the center of the bonding atoms, due to which no poles are generated and the bond so formed is called non-polar covalent bond. The examples are hydrogen, chlorine, fluorine. All the gases that are diatomic in nature or even triatomic can be termed as non-polar covalent compounds. Now we are going to study dipole moment. After the development of polarity between the molecules, The polar molecules are also called dipole molecules since they have dipole moment, which is defined as a product of magnitude of the positive or negative charges and the distance between the charges. It is represented by the symbol mu and the unit is debye. 1 debye is equal to 3.335 into 10 to the power minus 30 centimeter. It has both direction and magnitude, so it is a vector quantity. It is depicted by a small arrow which is pointing towards the electronegative center. Now the most important topic is the theory called VSEPR theory, a theory based on repulsive character of electron pairs in the valence shell of the atoms. The main postulates are covered as follows. It says that the exact shape of the molecule depends upon the number of electron pairs which are bonded or non-bonded around the central atoms. The electron pairs have a tendency to repel each other since they exist around the central atom and all the electron clouds are negatively charged. The electron pairs try to take such position so as to minimize the repulsion between them. The other criteria covered are: the valence shell is taken as a sphere where all the electron pairs are placed at the maximum distance in order to avoid repulsion and attraction. A multiple bond is treated as if it is a single electron pair and all the electron pairs taking part in the compound formation constitute the bond as single pairs. After understanding the VSEPR theory, let us move on to valence bond theory, which explains that while the formation of two atoms in order to form a molecule takes place, new attractive and repulsive forces begin to operate. The nucleus of one atom is attracted towards its own electron and the electron of the other atom starts attracting towards the nucleus. Also, the repulsive forces existing between the electrons of the two atoms and the nuclei of the two atoms. So all these attractive forces, they finally bring the two atoms closer, whereas the repulsive forces are responsible for pushing the molecules and the atoms apart.
So students, so far we have discussed so many definitions and new terms related to bond. Also, we have discussed how to compute dipole moment and we have computed the theory of VSEPR in order to resolve so many models of compounds. In the later stages of the videos, we'll also cover the topics such as orbitals overlapping. So wait for those videos and till then, practice the questions given in your NCERT textbook. Practice, take care, and thank you everyone.